Good morning, everybody. Yes. No, we have an echo. This is better. One moment. Next slide. That's a lot better. Welcome to you all on this introduction webinar, Orange Next, this series. We are going to do it in English because we have some guests from overseas, so they can understand what we are telling. I'm here together with Jos Blahi, CEO of the ICT Group, because I also would like to, let's say, place Orange Next within the group, particularly we are doing. The agenda, we will tell something about the company, a little bit about our approach, and give you an overview of our products, so that you have an understanding of what Orange Next is and our product portfolio. So let's kick off with Jos. Orange Next within the ICT group.
Good, thank you. Welcome everybody to this series of seven webinars, and this is the introductory one. And as the introduction, I'd like to say a little bit about the ICT Group. ICT Group has more than 1,000 professionals with all a passion for technology. And in 2016, we decided to really harvest on all those brilliant ideas we had in the company. And we were working on our own software, industrial software. By 2018, we found out that in a company where people are important and projects for customers are important, this could not interfere with the products and working with partners to enhance your products. So in 2018, we decided to split the group into a people's and projects part, which is still called ICT, and a products and partners part, which is called Orange Next. And since then, we've been growing rapidly with the enhancements of the software, where Hu is going to talk about. Hu, floor is yours.
Thank you, Jos. Yeah, we are in a beautiful surrounding of Rotterdam. In the middle of the center, we have a beautiful view, even up to Den Haag, I think. We currently are looking. We are very proud of being part of the Orange Next group. It's the ideal mother for us, for scalability. However, we consider ourselves at Orange Next to be a little bit different. With the exception of myself, we have a very young team. I think I am by far the oldest employee.
No, I'm by far.
Yeah, but not within Orange Next. Within Orange Next, I think I'm the oldest person. We have a very young team, different mindset, very product oriented. So they really like to work on our product suite. We are doing that with approximately 40 people at this moment. And I can say very successful. I brought on purpose some items here. We won last year the Microsoft Partner of the Year Award within the Microsoft community. Zebra awarded us with most innovative software solution for the proof of delivery solution. And lately, our newest award was the Gerard and Anton Philips Award. Who awarded us as the most innovative scale-up within the Brainport region. And for those who know the Brainport region around Eindhoven, this is the most clever part of the Netherlands. I can say that being here in Rotterdam, that Eindhoven is one of the cleverest areas in the Netherlands. When we started Orange Next in 2018, we quickly saw that Digital transformation was all about connecting people, devices, and data. All projects we did, also within the ICT group, we saw that if we do a digital transformation project, it always involves people, it always involves devices or assets, and it always is around turning around data into information. So that's where our start was, that our platform should consist of those main three elements. Besides software, you also need partners to collaborate with. We are very partner driven, that's why we say the four P's, the people, the projects on the ICT side, and the two P's on the Orange Next being products and partners. So we partner intensively with Microsoft, Zebra, Honeywell, KPN, all major players in the world of connectivity and cloud. So very partner driven. So I think that's good to mention there. Besides having solutions, it's also good to have a methodology. So how do we approach projects? And basically we do that via the 4C model, which is a model we developed ourselves. It's basically connecting your assets to gather information. Once you have the information, you are collecting it and turning that data into information. The third step is controlling it. So do clever things with it. And in the end, the fourth C is changing your business process or even your business model. Now, to implement that methodology, it's a different, it's a difficult word, Jos. Basically, what we do is when we first start talking about to customers about digital transformation, we do that outside in. So that means that we are not talking with our customers about the solutions, but we are talking about why they want to implement certain solutions or why they want to digitally transform at this moment. So we basically start at the 4C being change and then working way back. So how you should do that. Once we start realizing a project, then basically we start with the first part, namely connecting all the assets, connecting the people, collecting information, transforming that information, and controlling the information stream. We do that via a proof of value. We really call it proof of value, why we don't want to prove the technology. We want to prove the business value of our solutions. So challenges, in 20 days, we can do all four steps and take one use case and prove that digital transformation with our platform, with our solutions, will bring value to your company. So I would briefly like to take you through our product platform. Small delay, yeah. Through our product suite, as I said, the platform is built on three core products. Connecting people via the Mobile Next solution, connecting assets via the Connect solution, and connecting data via the Digital Next solution. These are our core products that we develop with a very wide functionality to cover these areas. Why a very wide functionality? Because we would like to have these three projects suitable for all markets. So we are not making it very specialized core products. We really widen the functionality so we can apply it to healthcare, to logistics, but also to production, for instance. Now, at a certain moment, you are into markets that require very specialized functionality, and at that moment we do not build that in our core products, but we build it as add-ons to our core products. So I will give you an example. The energy market, we are within the energy transition that requires very specific functionality because you want to have a product suitable for the energy providers. The energy operator, you want to provide a solution for large-scale enterprise consumable consuming customers, but you also want to supply a solution for small consumers, small scale consumers. That can be people like me or yours or you. So what we do then, we take our Connex platform, which is typically suitable for connecting devices, and we build an add-on called Energy Next, where you can do very specific things for the energy market. In this way, we do not limit ourselves in having a very strong development on our core products, but do apply or do have suitable solutions for very specific markets. It's not an and or question, it is more, we have customers that only are using our core solutions, and we have customers that are using our core plus our add-on solution. Now, once you have all those solutions in place, we have seen that we have, let's say, a domain solution. And what do I mean with a domain solution? For instance, I will take the smart factory or the smart buildings. To have a total smart building solutions, you need connectivity for your assets via Connext. You can have connectivity for your energy consumption via Energy Next. You can have your service and maintenance done via Mobile Next, where your service engineers are connected. So the bundle of and the core elements of our platform and the specific add-ons that we have built enables us to have a complete specific domain proposition where you can have a one turnkey, an end-to-end solution for that specific domain. So that's how we look into our product suite. So from our core products with add-ons towards end-to-end domain specific solutions. That gives an idea about our product range, Jos. You have seen implementations we have done. Anything to add to that?
Well, there is one USP which I like to elaborate on, and I've been working myself with one of the solutions in Mobile Next, and I can tell you the software is idiot-proof.
Yeah, another USP. Would be that all our products that we have developed are 100% cloud-based, 100% SaaS-based, very easy to implement. It was one of the requirements that Jos said in the beginning, we should have a recurring model.
Idiot-proof.
Idiot-proof. So it's 100% cloud-based, 100% SaaS-based, very easy to implement. So what I would like to do, I would like to take you through a few examples that we have to give you an idea. What we are doing. The first one is Ampelman, which is using our Connext solution. Ampelman is supplying a motion gangway to transport people from towards offshore facilities. So what I mean with that can be drills, that can be all platforms. And they would like to safely transport people from a boat to that offshore facility. Now I can tell you the waves that can go up to 8 meters. So it's very important that gangway is continuously adapted to those waves, because safe is the first priority of Ampelman. There are 400 sensors continuously monitoring the operation of that gangway. Now, very important for them is to monitor that. We are in an open sea, so connectivity is quite a challenge. Our Connect solution is able to deal with that challenge. So we are continuously monitoring 400 plus sensors to enable uptime, full uptime of the system, and that the gangway is ideally positioned towards the offshore facility. On the 24th of September, the webinar of Connex will take place, and Ampelman will itself explain exactly how they have implemented and what the implementation has brought them so far. So I definitely recommend, if you are into connecting devices, to have, let's say, a view at that webinar. Then on the 17th of November, sorry, 17th of September, so next week, we will host the webinar Digital Next Search, which I think is one of our most innovative solutions. Yes, all solutions are very, very, let's say, impressive, but Digital Next is, I think, at this moment, they're having a lot of traction. Because it's very, very innovative, and the business case is simple, the implementation is relatively simple. The example that I would like to take out is ESA. ESA is into the world of ship building, vessels, dredging, wet mining. That's their business. It's, of course, it's a big company. Their projects are very complex. You can imagine building and maintaining a vessel for dredging is a very complex project. The stakes are high. Uptime is extremely important. Very cost intensive solutions, very cost intensive vessels, and you do not want to have that going down. So ESA has a lot of service technicians, a lot of engineers, a lot of maintenance engineers, but they also have a lot of complex projects. And you can understand, in the meantime, we have over 1 million technical oriented documents. So in case something happens, a service technician, a service or a maintenance technician wants to find answers quickly. You can say build a search solution that searches through multiple systems, then you will get, like with Google, you will get results. However, we added some very, very clever things to the search solution. So it's called cognitive search, so that we are adding vocabulary, company specific vocabulary, we are adding algorithms to the search solution. And at this moment, a service technician of ESA gets, within 2 seconds, a very good, a very impressive search result, specifically on his search term, in his language, within 2 seconds. As I said, the September 17, John Code will host together with ESA and BAM webinar, explaining you all the ins and outs of our Digital Next Search solution. Another one is HelloFresh. HelloFresh came to us, I think, 1.5 years ago with a question: how can we establish the happy road to our customers? So that's the why question. So they really thought outside in. As you can imagine, they have shortened the supply chain. They are bringing fresh food, fresh vegetables directly from the farmers, making a recipe and bringing it to your door. It's very important that the delivery is going almost 100%. So the interaction that HelloFresh wants with their customers is extremely important. That was the why, that was their question. How can we have the most optimal customer experience by using a digitized solution? And are you a HelloFresh customer?
I am a HelloFresh customer and I have good experience. But I've also been testing the system one day.
Yeah.
By bringing parcels to customers. And I can tell you, as a deliverer, it is a real good experience. And most importantly, in my opinion, for HelloFresh, the advantage for HelloFresh is that they have now more or less no-shows, I would say, less no-shows, where you have to take the parcel back and bring it back again, than ever before.
Yeah.
And that's the major advantage for HelloFresh.
Yeah. Yeah, as I said, Jos and I drove a day, took a day, dived into the world of a HelloFresh driver. We got a van, HelloFresh. We thought we could do a sort of a demo route or a test route, But when we came at the depot, we saw that we had to do 58 stops.
Production, full production.
Yeah, with a theoretical time window at the start of the route of 15 minutes. But in the end, it's a five minute time window that you have to cover. So we were really chasing like, we were the two of us. So I'm very impressed by the fact that a driver can do that alone, because we were with two. And it was also a game to be on time. What did we deliver? Our mobile Next solution, which runs basically on every device. So it can be a ruggedized device, but it can also be any mobile phone. And with that, you are in continuously contact with both the hub, so the depot, with the customer service department, and with the customer itself. So if we came, and we can now talk about personal experience, if we came at the door and the customer is not home, you easily press a button, you can call, you can chat with the customer, you can tell, okay, I will be home in, or I'll be back in 2 minutes. So what we created for HelloFresh was a total solution where, in the meantime, 1,200 drivers only in the Benelux are using it. Full interaction with the customer, and they expressed lately they are extremely satisfied with how the project has been handled. The last one that I just wanted to go through with you is, I think, the perfect example of, let's say, our total portfolio, because Going Dutch is basically, we are going to build the cycling community of the future. I think 5 or 10 years ago we would think, okay, just put very good asphalt, very good cycling lane.
Tarmac.
Yeah, and everybody will start cycling. But it's not only about the physical infrastructure anymore. It's about providing cyclists the ultimate cycling experience. We are currently implementing it at Schiphol, under the name Going Dutch, together with BAM, together with Microsoft, and together with Schiphol itself. And it basically has three main drivers. Keeping the airport accessible. Yes, we are in a corona period, so people are not on big numbers going to Schiphol. But we know that the accessibility of Schiphol, there are 66,000 people working there, is very important. The second one is vitality. We as employers want our personnel to be vital. And what's better than in a day, take your bicycle instead of being in the car, in a traffic jam. So it's vitality is the second one. And the third one is environment. We want to reduce our carbon footprint. So one of the best things to do that is leave your car at home and start cycling. But to get people on their bike, you need to do a few things. As I said, it's not only about having the cycling lane itself. It's about taking away all worries, taking away all the concerns, and getting them on the bike. So it has to do with speed. It has to do with weather, clothing, administration. And what we, together with our partners, did within Going Dutch, so we implemented our product. So now the bicycle itself interacts with the traffic lights. So we will have a green wave on Schiphol, so cyclists will be preferred above cars. It will interact with the speed regulation, so because there are people that are biking 45 kilometers per hour on the speed pedelecs, the e-bikes going 25, the normal bikes going 15. Now, to have it, let's say, in a safely way, you can apply speed regulation, automatic speed regulation on the cycling lanes. We developed an app where the complete administration of your, let's say, kilometers is done for the financial coverage, because in the Netherlands it's allowed to give your employees at least 19 cents per kilometer if they come with bike. So not only with car, also with bike. And as Dutch people, we are very, very, let's say,
Scrooge.
Yeah. So money is very important. So a financial driver is definitely there. So we are currently implementing our platform and the add-ons on Area 30 around Schiphol. You will definitely hear a lot about that in the coming months because it's basically a blueprint for every airport in the Netherlands, but also outside there. And it's very, very innovative. It's very heavily supported by our Ministry of Infrastructure and Water because they also see the benefits of having more people going on their bike. That's just a few examples. As we told, we will have 7 webinars in the upcoming weeks. Each webinar will take one of those examples or one of our total product suite and take a deep dive in there. So please, let's say, register and take a look at that. I just want to end, or let's say, I was talking about the proof of value challenges. It's also the slogan of the ICT group, also challenges. We do have the proof of value, a 20-day challenge. So in that 20 day, we will connect your device, your assets, or your people. We will set up a cloud infrastructure for you. We will have some analytics on the data, and we will help you in driving insights of your business. Challenges is our, let's say, slogan for today. In case you have any questions for me, I just list here my personal information. So either send me a mail, give me a call, and I'm happy to explain you more about what I've told. I would really like to already thank you for your participation and really put some extra attention on the next webinar next week, September 17. John Coat on behalf of Orange Next, together with Bavik and Kitting, will host the cognitive search webinar.
Same time,
same place. I don't know that for sure. Normally, same time, same place. I hope this gave you some insight and some introduction into the Orange Next organization and the products and the solutions and the projects that we have done. I would like to thank you for your attention. Jos, maybe a small closing word from you.
Well, again, since we've been separating Orange Next from our projects and people's business, they have really grown rapidly. And that's not only because these people are young, that's not only because these people are devoted and dedicated, but that's because the products, I should say, are excellent. Take a view of it in the next webinars, and thank you for your attention.
Greetings from Rotterdam.